I want to introduce you to one of my favorite winter bloomers. Come on in. I just have to show you one of these spectacular shrubs. This is a camellia, and this variety of camellia is called Camellia japonica, and that simply means that it's a camellia from Japan. Now, what's interesting about Camellia japonica is that it blooms in late winter. It can be a beautiful addition to a garden, but if you have a place where you can bring them indoors, like a conservatory, a small greenhouse, even a sunroom where there's some humidity, you can grow camellias all year long. We'll just want to take them outside in their containers during the growing season so they can enjoy humidity and lots of filtered light. Now you'll notice these are all in containers. And one of the great reasons to grow a camellia in a container is, well, you can display them like this and you can have them bloom early in the winter, but you can also manage the soil. You see, camellias love acidic soil. And if you live in an area where your soil is sweet or alkaline or chalky, you're gonna have a lot of trouble growing this particular plant, which is a real shame. And what a fascinating family of plants. You see, Camellia japonica, this one, can take temperatures down to freezing, 32 degrees, and be all right. You wanna make sure that the buds are protected, and as long as the buds are in bud form like this, they're probably okay with cold weather. But I'll tell you, once the bloom opens, they're very susceptible to the cold and to frost. Now let's talk about pest problems. If you look for just a moment here, camellias can often have problems that occur on the underside of the leaf in the way of whiteflies, mealybugs, and scale. And the best way to deal with this is to spray them with a dormant oil. It will actually suffocate the insect or the egg or the pupa of the insect. Feeding camellias, well, yes, it's very important. You want to use an acidifying fertilizer and you want to fertilize them on a regular basis, because to produce big blooms like this, believe me, these plants are heavy feeders. Now, if you're enjoying these tips on growing camellias and other things, make sure you tell a friend and subscribe to eHow Home.